Not my favorite. To me, irresponsible critic,
yep.
in my opinion. But everybody else, you're allowed not to like or like.
I like it. And I said, people who don't like it.
Ms. Garvey, you sit
yeah,
back
thank you. Tight two is all close ups.
Well, I think that was one of my best films.
It's we still need you to go back in your.
It's just when somebody says, well, I mean, the educators that I did that picture for, they loved the picture. They said it was a perfect portrayal, so somebody shouldn't say it's not. Let's talk about Runaway Bride.
You had to be happy last night hearing all the laughs because you were sitting in the back, and yes. we all laughed and we loved it, and everybody was happy, and we stayed through the very end of the credits even.
You did. There's a lot of credits, but we did a little different form in Runaway Bride because the beginning kind of has a sense of urgency. Mm-hmm.
Filibuster about the Teamsters and all that stuff.
You don't want to put everybody's name right in the front.
But this movie, some movies just work, and this one definitely just, I felt so good when I left, and I don't know, it's magic, isn't it, sometimes when you put these movies together.
You're doing it as we were doing it. We knew we were doing some fun stuff, and we were laughing. And they would try anything, you know. And I would switches things in the middle of everything. I said, you know, I got a better way for her to go up the aisle. I'm going to have to have somebody hold on to her wedding dress. And they go, what are you talking about? It cost a fortune. Mm-hmm. We'll fix it. And then I say, it's a little quiet in this scene, Richard. Maybe you should run. And he does like a snake dance that everybody loves, right. The snake dance he does, which he kind of made the whole thing up, and I just let the camera roll, so there was some ad-libbing in there that's quite funny.
In hit records and in hit movies, it's sometimes those little bitty things that make the difference, you know, that just leave you that little candy.
Yeah, it's just an extra beat, because when Rich and Julia get together, they're very comfortable with each other. They have the romantic chemistry, mm-hmm. of course, but they also have a comfort zone where they can try any kind of comedy and the other will help them. And the supporting cast was superb. So
they've both grown up a lot, though, in 10 years since you've worked with them, though, haven't they?
Oh, I think so. They'll try it. I remember in the opera scene in Pretty Woman, Julia said to the guy, don't bring out any props or stuff because Gary will make me do something crazy with him. I had her doing a thing with the opera glasses. Now she's saying, what should I do now? You know, and she does a whole thing with the
just
bell.
Just much more confident, right, as an
very
actress.
Confident that physical comedy done by an elegant girl like Julia Roberts is okay.
And but Richard was already confident when you hired him the last time.
Well, he was confident, but not so much in comedy. He didn't quite know. I'm very good at chasing people. Sometimes with a gun, you know, I do those action pictures. Right? Chasing the girl is a whole different thing, but we developed a way he could do it. And I think, as I said, she just did something with Hugh Grant. I think in Runaway Bride, Richard does like a Cary Grant, and he does some charming stuff that's very funny. And the young kids like it. They like the banter between this couple, because teenagers are also trying to find a relationship.
Are you that involved? You're involved with everything. You're the big man. But I mean, were you that involved in getting with Kathy Nelson on the music that's in this movie? Because this music is almost another star.
Well, in this age of filmmaking, it's so competitive that after you make the movie, then you got to put in the record album.
Yeah.
And you don't want the record album suddenly to take over the movie and ruin the story. That's why I use this girl, Kathy Nelson, on the last couple of pictures, because she knows how to take a song and place it someplace.
But you've got hit records in this movie, which is the good thing. I've been told by the big boss in Atlanta at one of the radio stations that I Love You, Martina McBride, is going to be a smash hit
Heck
record.
Heck of a song, Martina McBride.
And that's going to be, we're talking about maybe if it all plays right, and I know Martina, hope good luck to her, you know, Grammys and Oscar nomination type things.
Well, it's a great song, and it's done in a way that I think is the visual stuff they're doing in that scene is great. Julia,
and you
really
can't hurry
it.
Love is, you know, the Dixie Chicks have got something, so
yes.
You've got a hit album and a hit movie, so you did good.
Could be the highlight of my career. I'm going to be in the Dixie Chicks video.
Uh-oh.
I don't know what I'm playing, but I'm going to do stuff. No, the music of Runaway Bride, I think, is a big extra asset. And we'll make you go for the music alone. Go for the 5 wedding dresses Julia wears. That's worth it.
Whatever it takes to get people to buy the tickets, Gary will do.
He'll
beg. He'll cry. He'll do whatever it takes.
But mostly, I can guarantee laughs.
Laughs. He's got laughs. Nice seeing you again.
Okay, thank you. I'm glad you like that.